Hi everyone, hope that you are well. In this video I want to talk about the correlated color temperature. We have known as CCT as an abbreviation, but as mentioned early, CCT stands for correlated color temperature. Usually you can find it in the product description under, for example, 4000, like in this example, we have this luminaires used, and here we have 4000 K. So this means 4000 K. It represents the correlated color temperature, and this one in the lighting industry we say it is as neutral light can be perceived. Usually you encounter this type of CCT in office applications, schools, even industry, but as I said, it's more for eight hours job where the people are usually working on the working stations, or that's the most common CCT that you or we encounter in this moment into the market. I want to make a comparison by letting you know, and as well visualize, I think that's the best thing they want to highlight in this video. What does it mean a 2700 K? What does it mean 6500 CCT from warm white, which is 2700, for example, which was founded in the incandescent lamps, to 6500, which we characterize as cool white. So I would just use these six luminaires in the beginning. You need to go on this side, and we have this colorimetric data, and we have the spectrum. You see by default, the CCT is 4000 Kelvin and the CRI 90. The CRI is the color rendering index, so how good you can perceive the colors let's say, furniture or object inside of that that space illuminated by artificial light, compared with the natural light which is coming from the sun. For time being, I will just use the six luminaires. We will have this one as reference. So this one, I will not change the CCT, and we will let it 4000 Kelvin as it stands here. And I will just change the CCT on the other six. I will have also, I choose this space because we have also the indirect light, so in the ceiling, and also direct on the desk area, just to highlight better from the perspective of visualizing the CCT. So let's start with this. I will go for incandescent, for example, just to compare it. So here you have the spectrum of a standard lamp with incandescent, which was the CRI the best, but the CCT is around 2722. And after you choose this one, we just apply. Result of course will be invalid. We will just recalculate again. And you see now we have the same CCT in the entire room, and the wall washer remains the same on 4000 Kelvin. And now let's start the calculation, and let's have the first overview of how it looks warm white. And important as well is the luminance will not change, so you will have the same lux level of 381 indifferent of the CCT. Even you see it more warm when you go on the 2700 Kelvin, or you go on the neutral light, which is a 4000, or you go cool white, which is 6500. This value all the time will remain the same. You can see it as well on this part of results overview. So now you can spot a difference also on the ceiling, but as well on the wall washer. So you see the wall washer that is more, let's say, cold white compared with the rest of the room. So that's a highlight, and I want to let it as it is. Now I will just choose, we will change once again, we'll go to LED this time, and I want to go, for example, on, let's say, 6,800, oh no, 5,400 we have here. We can also, let's say, I'll just go even more cold. I think this one is 6,800, and apply. We have also the spectrum, you see, more on the blue part, and we have lower on the reddish or, and let's say, warm colors. Let's apply it once again. And as remember, this one is 4000 Kelvin. And now let's recalculate once again. I just want everyone understands what does it mean warm white, what does it mean cool white, and what does it mean a neutral white. And here we go again. Lux levels stays the same as mentioned early, but look here, when you compare the ceiling, the brightness, let's say, or the visual aspect, and then the wall washer, which we see it's a big, big difference in the 4000. It looks more warm than compared with the 6,873. So that's a really big, big difference. So I hope that you get what does it mean, a CCT from now on, and which CCT you should use for different applications. You know, when you have, let's say, bakery products in the shop, you go for warm white. When you have refrigerator or stuff which are need to place to the cold, then definitely you need to go with a neutral or cool white, especially as well for let's say walking path, for example. Usually you go for the neutral white. Okay, I move back once again. Now I just want to show a little bit what does it mean if we have a LED red, for example. I just want to play a little bit here in this case, just to make a scenario. When you change the spectrum completely to red, then the entire room will be just red. So this is also, for example, perspective, and when you use, for example, RGB, or you want to play with different, just a single color, let's say, if it's red, if it's blue, it's green, whatever color you want to use. Yeah, so I hope that everything is clear. What does it mean, the correlated color temperature, and how you can change it from in Dialux Evo, choose different, let's say, light sources like LED, incandescent halogen, fluorescent lamps, whatever luminance are you using, and what does it mean, what's the difference in the spectrum when you go 3000, 4000, as you can see in this table. Very nice pictures realized by Dialux, and you can have a better overview. Another point, how you can change this spectrum, you can adjust the white balance here. So you see, that's 5000. You can do it manually in this case, but I would prefer the other way around, which I show you. This version, I think, is more, for me, it's much, much better to use that one. But that's just my personal opinion. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope this information that I share with you are important and useful when you establish the lighting projects, and especially, as I said, when you choose the correlated color temperature for your application. Please give a like to this video, subscribe to my channel if you didn't do it yet, and yeah, stay safe, and until next time, I wish you all the best. Bye bye.